Good day, students. Today we are discussing topic titled Scalar and Vector Quantities. Vector quantities are different from scalar quantities in the sense that scalar quantities has only magnitude but no direction, but vector quantities has both magnitude and directions. Now let's define scalar quantities. Scalar quantities are those quantities that have only magnitude or numerical value but no direction. For example, a man moves 2 meters. That's numerical value. Without telling us the direction where he moves, we refer that as distance. Is that okay? When you say the car moves 2 meters per second, that 2 meters per second is the magnitude or numerical value without telling us the direction where it moves, whether it is northeast or northwest. Examples of, and you can still see speed in terms of kilometer per hour. You might see sometimes meter per second, sometimes in kilometer per hour, you see speed. But when you introduce direction to it, whether northeast or northwest, you change it from speed to velocity because you have introduced directions. Okay, example of scalar quantities are length or distance, area, volume, density, temperature, and many more. Let's go to another way of solving scalars, of solving problem, is by algebraic method. For example, when you want to add volumes together, just go directly by saying 5 centimeter cube plus 10 centimeter cube give you 15 centimeter cube. Now let's go to vector quantities. Vector quantities are those quantities that have both magnitude and directions. And in this case, when you say a man moves 2 meters in the instantly direction, that means that you are giving us the direction where he moves. It's no more distance but displacement. The man moves, or the car moves 2 meters per second due north. That is velocity because of direction. When you say move 2 meters per second due north, you have introduced direction, that is a velocity. Or you say the man moves 2 kilometers per hour, you have three in the easterly direction, you have changed it from speed to velocity. These are the way to differentiate when something is a scalar or vector quantity. And the way problem is being solved under vector quantities by geometrical method. Okay? Now, there are those quantities which have only magnitude or that are scalar quantity, only magnitude or numerical value but no direction. For example, a temperature of 100 degrees centigrade is a number, it's on scale, it has no directional property. A speed of 50 km per hour measure in the straight path or circular path is a scalar quantity since no direction was indicated. Scalars are added by ordinary algebraic method, e.g. addition of volume, 5 cm cube plus 10 cm cube equals 15 cm cube. Examples of scalar quantities are length, distance, that is length, that was distance, mass, volume, density, time, speed, temperature, and energy. Vector quantities, they are those quantities which have both magnitude or size and directions. Another word for magnitude is size. For example, thus a displacement is a distance measure in a specified direction. E.g., let's see how you can get displacement from a statement. A bird flies a distance of 100 km in a northeasterly direction. You see? Velocity is speed in a specified direction. Don't just say speed, you have to put it in a specified direction, whether north, east, southwest, and the rest. e.g. a car travels due west at 90 km per hour. Vectors are added by geometrical methods. Let's see addition of vectors. Algebraic method. We have algebraic method and geometrical method of solving problem in additions of vectors. Let's see the algebraic method. You see the arrow pointed in the easterly direction, due east, t plus q, you add them together, 10 km per hour plus 30 km per hour will give you 40 km per hour. Is that okay? Now, 5 newton the force and p 4 newton, 5 newton for the p and q 4 newton, you move towards the point towards the east, you add them together, they both point towards the east, you have 9 newton. You can see 5 newton the force p point toward the east, for the force q 4 newton point toward the west, different direction, you subtract them and allow the arrow to point towards where you have the greatest value, the higher value, that's to show that it moves towards the east. The man moves 2 kilometers due east and later change directions and move 4 kilometers due west. You subtract 4 minus 2 and point your arrow, the resultant arrow, due west to show that 4 kilometers is greater than 2 kilometers. Now, let's see how geometrical method can be solved. You have the arrow, the man moves 3 kilometers due east and later changes his course and move 4 kilometers due south. What is the resultant of the movement? Put the arrow, resultant of the movement, find the alpha. Call this B, call this one C. Now, since you can only use Pythagoras theorem when you have a right angle triangle. Now, using Pythagoras theorem, to find the resultant R, line AB, which is the longest line, square it, equals to the square of the other side, line AC squared plus line BC squared. Now AB is R squared equals, what's AC? 3 squared plus 4 BC 4 squared, which is equal to 9 plus 16. R squared equals 25. Now find the square root of both sides. Square root cancel these two. We have R to be 5 kilometers. Therefore, the resultant R equals 5 kilometers. Now let's get the direction. Direction alpha is the opposite line to this angle. Opposite is adjacent and is hypotenuse. Okay, that means I use SOHCAHTOA. SOHCAHTOA. I use a tan alpha equals opposite over adjacent. I'm using this. What are opposite? 4 over adjacent 3. And see there, when you divide, you have 1.3333. Alpha equals tan inverse of 1.3333. Your alpha, here's your calculator, you have 53.13 degree. That is direction. Please take note, when it's being inclined right angle triangle, that's when you can use Pythagoras theorem to solve this problem under geometrical method. This is the end of our class. Please subscribe to my channel so that you have access to the latest video. Have a wonderful day.